Hello, Crafty Budgeters, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Brittany. On this channel, we are working to craft a budget and a lifestyle to become debt-free. Y'all, it is day 5 of our November Video Extravaganza. If it sounds like I'm whispering, I am, because again, I am up around 5 a.m. in the morning doing this video. My son is upstairs asleep, so I do not want to wake him up, but I had to make sure I got this video out for y'all. So sorry if I'm not screaming like I normally am, but y'all, I'm making these videos happen no matter what time of day it is, so you're just gonna have to deal with it being a little bit more quiet than normal. If this is your first time watching one of my videos, hello. I'm working to get my family out of our $175,000 worth of debt that we started with in 2020. And yesterday I shared where we are at with our November 2021 debt number. Y'all don't want to miss it. It's one of my favorite videos that I do at the end of the month for our extravaganza. But today we are going to be checking in and closing out on the month of November. I know there's still, well, today's the last day of November, so, and we are going to be walking through the December budget. Crazy, it's December, the last month of the year, but we are about to get going. If you are not subscribed to the Crafty Budgeter fam, what are you waiting on? Hit that subscribe button. We have fun over here. If you enjoy these types of videos, make sure that you like and comment. I respond back to all of your comments, but we are going to get started. I'm excited. Let's go. Y'all, I decided to keep Sebastian in here with us for this breakdown. Hello, Sebastian. I know Snaps never gets to be in with the videos because he's a little bit too tall, but that's okay. He'll be back with us on Sunday for Cash Stuffing Sunday. So I want to just walk through our end of the month closeout. Now, you might be saying, like, Brittany, how do you already know? Because today's the end of the month, and shouldn't you, like, just check out everything after the month has closed? And yes, but pretty much I've gone through and just for what we budgeted for our categories over here for this week, so paycheck number 4, I just made it like we used all of it, and just for ease and making sure that I can get this video at closing the budget, it just was easier for me to do it this way. So let's quickly walk through. So for our starting balance, you will see that we do have a big increase in our amount, so our starting balance, and that is because of our side income stuffing. So I don't add the side income into our what we budget for the beginning of the month, but you will see the difference. So we ended our total starting balance of $7,756.44. Now, again, this is not our full salary, not all of our income, because I don't share what we put to mortgage, I don't share what we put to tithe, I don't share what our salary is, but when all of that is taken into account, you get the $7,700. So when we move down, everything stayed the same for our fixed expenses, so nothing changed here, but the total amount changed because now we have more money that we started with. When you move over to the variable expenses, so we budgeted for 5, and these are the ones that I kind of really like to talk about, because those are the ones that we have a little bit more wiggle room to go over budget or under budget. So groceries, we budgeted $550 and we only spent $489.53. So you'll see what we're doing for December. Pretty much what I do is look to see how we do from month to month, and based on how we do, then I make changes for the next month, depending on whether I think we need a little bit more money or I think we can cut back. Eating out, we budgeted $200 and we spent $289.45. So we went over for eating out. Gas, we went over $8.81. So not horrible. Personal, we were under. So we spent $177.27. So personal miscellaneous, with split between my husband and I didn't really use a lot of the personal money this month. And my husband, I just account that he uses everything. Miscellaneous, we went over a little bit, $113.53 from our 80. And then our buffer, for our buffer, we went over. So we only accounted for $101 and we went over about $200. And for the buffer, I put money into our buffer account every paycheck. So even though we went over, I did account for it in the budget every week. So all of that comes down to this total remaining. And yeah, so this total remaining. And then this is how we did for our plan. So for the debt snowball, emergency fund, and sinking funds. So we were able, debt snowball, two snaps, to put $2,866 to our debt snowball, which is awesome. For our emergency fund, we did the standard $200. And you know, this month we had to take a little bit of money away from our debt snowball. I mean, from our emergency fund, because I needed a new phone. The phone came yesterday. It is a little bit different. The difference between the iPhone 10 and the iPhone 13, it's a little bit, well, I got the Pro. It's a little bit heavier and then more of like a squared shape, but grateful that I was able to get a new phone. And then sinking funds, we put $320 compared to the $110. So between our side income and just a little bit of additional money here and there from our paychecks, we were able to stuff a little bit more in those categories. And that comes to that we had a remaining of $8.47. So we stayed in black all month. So, well, technically, you will see that like we have red on here, but when it comes to what happens for the whole month, we stayed in black. We had an all black everything week, so that is, or all black everything month, so that is awesome. So two snaps to us for that. So now what I want to do is, now we're going to walk through our December budget kit and we're going to set up our December budget. All right, so this is the December budget kit. When you watch this video, it is up and ready to go in my Etsy shop. I made a promise to myself that I was going to not just do the black and white budget kit. I really wanted to make sure that I got out another themed version for the end of the year. Y'all, I couldn't give you all of the budget kits and then stop in December. Like, what would I have been doing? So that is up on the Etsy shop for you to get the bundle. We'll walk through the bundle and then we'll go through our monthly budget. The nice and exciting thing that I can't wait is that next year I will be using our Elevated Life Co. workbook duo. But let me know if you are interested in me still doing the themed ones. I haven't decided whether I'm going to keep doing the themed ones or not since I'm using the workbook duo, but I would love your thoughts and opinions about that. So December, y'all, do you see the colors? It's just like gives me the winter, but also Christmas vibe. You see the holly. It just is awesome. So you get your cover page, your two-page calendar spread. You then get your, like always, monthly budget, your two paycheck budgets that are in here, your sinking funds tracker, your debt breakdown, expense tracker, weekly check-in, and then you also get a cash envelope breakdown, which I just don't have in here. All of this budget kit is $10. I believe it's $10 or 10. Yeah, I think it's $10. And this month I'm also just selling the paycheck budget sheet by itself for $1.50. So if you're interested, check out the Elevated Life Co. Check out the Crafty Budgeter Etsy shop for you to purchase your printables. You can download it, print it out at home, or print it out at a print shop. This printable that you see right now, I printed at home with I believe it's a 24 pound paper. And I just really like the way it looks. So let's go over what I have on my calendar. I've already gone through and added all of my bills. Y'all, let me just tell you, I couldn't find, well, my black pen ran out and it's in the other room and I wasn't going to the other room. So we used a blue pen to this month. I also couldn't find my highlighter. Why can't I find anything in my office this morning? So I was just going to highlight it with like a random color, but I wanted to keep that consistent. So when you see this the next time, the gray highlighter will be on the bills. So the way that I do my two-page calendar spread is that in the beginning of the month, I write down all of my bills where they are laid out in the calendar, because I'm a paycheck budgeter. So whenever I get paid, I pay all of the expenses, all of the bills from the Friday to Thursday. And it just helps me visually see out, and that helps me plan out each paycheck budget. To go over the goals, the goal for this month is to pay off our timeshare. Y'all, I believe It's $2,999 that we have left, which that is getting paid off, which is awesome. I want to do two budget-related videos. This month, I did a, for November, I did the workspace behind the scenes put on by Chrissy from The Mom Life, and I also did a using Google Sheets to budget, and like once that money hits, how I plan out the budget for each week. I'm gonna do two family activities. I would like to meal plan, that's always on there, and stay within the grocery budget, and then enjoy break. So my employer is giving us off the whole week of Christmas and leading up to New Year's, so I'm really grateful for that. These are the categories, so groceries, eating out, personal, gas, and miscellaneous. And then I forgot to put on here that it is Christmas. So awesome. And then New Year's Eve as well. I guess I put this on here. New Year's Eve. I don't think we have any birthday. Oh, yes, we do. We do have a birthday in December. I want to make sure I have the right day before I write it down. But my nephew's birthday is in December. So now, like I said, these are the two, this is your monthly budget and then your paycheck budget. What we're gonna do is work through our monthly budget. I will come right back with you and go over it. And that's how we will close out this video. Okay, so this is our budget for December, but I also just want to say that for another goal for the month of December, I didn't write it on here because I don't think it's going to happen, but the goal is to get to $100,000 by the end of this year. So by the end of this month, the debt number will be $100,000. I am at $106,000 right now. And everybody that watched my video yesterday is like, you can do it. We think you can do it. I really want to do it, but I don't know if it's realistic. So I didn't want to write it on there, but I think I wanted to say it out loud. So that way, if it happens, I can just be like, remember in the video, I said that I didn't think it was going to happen. And then it happened. And then we can scream and just be excited and give 50 million two snaps. So let's see. Let's see if we can make it happen. Literally, money's gonna have to fall out of the sky, but you all know me. Like, if I have a goal, I'm really gonna try everything in my power to get to it. Because wouldn't starting 2022 with $100,000 worth of debt be like, just sound awesome? Anyway, so starting balance is $6,105.86. Again, this is not sharing our salary, what we put to ties, what we put to mortgage. This is just after all of that, what we are left with. These are our fixed expenses. Fixed expenses are the expenses that come every month. You pretty much know what the bill is. It might fluctuate depending on the season, depending on the quarter, but pretty much these bills, if you don't pay them, someone's going to call. Like I said, someone's going to call you. You're going to get something in the mail. Someone's going to get shut off. So daycare, $101. This is because I've already accounted for the child tax credit. Apple, $34.64. And this is already including our Apple Music, Canva, as well as our storage. Timeshare, $201.21. Trying to get this paid. This is getting paid off. It's getting how it's happening. Gym is $34.95. Hulu is $21.71. Car insurance, $148.37. Car wash, not, ooh, I said wash wrong. I sound like, I think my grandmother, my nan used to say it like that. Car wash is $19.95. Loans is $469.50. After January, this is definitely going to go back up because the two remaining loans are Fed Loan and Great Lakes will be starting again. So yeah, utilities is $575. So this number is higher than months prior because since we got new phones, both my husband and I, our bill's going to go up about $90. So I added that in. Peloton is $41.34. And then our life insurance is $139.19. So all of that comes to $2,676.86. I take that from our starting balance and we have $3,429 and that we're going to be working with for the variable expenses and the plan. So coming over to the variable expenses, so for groceries, we're budgeting $475. This is a lot less than what we gave last month. Last month we gave $550 and we didn't use as much. And because I'm trying to put as much money as I can to the debt snowball, I think groceries is an area that we can try to just cut back on a little bit. Eating out is getting the normal $50 a month, $50 a week, $200. Gas is getting $100 a week, $400. Personal has come down a little bit, so to $200 for both my husband and I. Miscellaneous came down a little bit, $75. And then we always have at least $100 for our buffer. So that gives us $1,450. Subtract that by the remaining, gives us $1,979 that we have to go towards the plan. Debt snowball, this is going to be the standard $1,629. That is how much every month now that we are putting to our debt. Now we put more into it if we get additional money or whatever we get for Etsy and in our YouTube channel, if I do a panel or a workshop, the money that goes towards debt, that is what gets added to this debt snowball. So we need this to get to at least $2,999. Oh gosh, we've got a lot of work to do this month. Emergency funds getting the standard $200, and sinking funds, I gave it an additional couple of dollars, so it's at $150. So all of that comes to $1,979. We are a zero-based budget family, so every cent, every penny has a place to go. And like I say, every month, this is the plan. So the goal is that this is where we stay within this budget. If we come under budget, great. We have rollover money that can go towards our priorities. The goal is that we don't go over budget. If we go over budget because life happens, we have buffers and a way to move money around. But this is what I would like our December budget to end up looking like and to have another all black everything month, which is awesome. So y'all, that is the budget for December. December is coming tomorrow, Wednesday, December 1st, crazy. Like always, I'm speaking it into existence. That is going to be a blessed month. I pray that you have a great end of the year and you just enjoy time with your family and with your loved ones and enjoy some break if you are able to have one. I'm speaking, this is going to be a great month. We are about to do some damage on this debt. I hope that is the same for you if you are working off on paying off debt as well, but also just reaching your other personal finance goals. So y'all, that is the end of our November video extravaganza. I didn't think it was going to happen, but y'all, when you love what you do, and I really love this YouTube channel and sharing my journey with you, I will make sure that means I have to stay up late at night or be up early in the morning to get these videos out and to share this journey with you. I'll make it happen. But y'all know I usually go into hibernation after my extravaganzas just because it's been a lot. 5 videos in 5 days is no joke. But I hope you enjoyed all of them. I will see you on Saturday. Maybe even not. I probably will see you on Sunday. Definitely will see you on Sunday for Cash Stuffing Sunday. Have a great rest of your day, great rest of your week. See ya. Also, make sure you check out the Elevated Life Co. Workbook Duo. It is on sale for $50 until this Thursday, December 2nd. And then we are doing the official launch on December 3rd. Have a great day. Bye-bye.